Tayammum. In their books, the scholars keep stressing, generation after generation, that Islamic legislation does not leave anything that comes to a person's mind, but it elaborates on it, so as to surround a Muslim with a very wide range of rules which make him able to see matters clearly and make his life easy without any confusion or lack of understanding. One of the proofs that the scholars show to illustrate this above rule is tayammum. Tayammum linguistically means intending and striving towards something. And in Islamic law, it means wiping the face and hands with clean soil with the intention of purification. As Allah, exalted is He, says, and when you don't find water, then perform tayammum with clean earth and rub your faces and hands with it. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, I have been given five things which have not been given to anyone else before me. Allah made me victorious by causing my enemies to fear me up to a distance of 1 month's journey. The earth has been made for me and my followers a place for praying and a means to perform tayammum, which means to purify oneself for prayer. Therefore, anyone of my followers can pray anywhere and at any time that this salah or prayer is due. Tayammum becomes compulsory in the absence of water, or when one is unable to use water, or when a risk is attached to using water to purify oneself for worship, like salah. However, tayammum is only recommended for acts for which purification is only recommended, like reading the Quran. According to Islamic legislation, one is allowed to perform tayammum when there is no water, due to Allah's saying, and when you don't find water, then perform tayammum with clean earth and rub your faces and hands with it. But a person is not considered to be lacking water if he has not searched for it. Similarly, it is allowed when one is incapable of using water, even when it is available. Such an example is when a sick and or elderly person who cannot move and has no one to help him or her perform the ablution. It is also allowed when one fears he will be harmed by using water because he is ill or the weather is extremely cold, as the Prophet, peace be upon him, approved of the action of Amr ibn al-As, may Allah be pleased with him, when he led his people in prayer, and he had performed tayammum due to the extreme cold. And finally, tayammum is an alternative for purifying oneself with water if a Muslim is far away from others or on a long journey with no water except a little for him to drink, and he is not able to get other water. If someone has no choice but to perform tayammum, he should strike the soil or dust with his hands once, then blow into the palms of the hands to reduce the particles therein. Next, he should wipe the face with the palms once, and then wipe the back of both hands by wiping the back of the right hand with the palm of the left, and the back of the left hand with the palm of the right. Before he performs tayammum, he must have the intention that he is purifying himself for worship. Also, he must follow a sequential order, starting with the face and then the hands. He must also be brisk when performing a tayammum by wiping the hands immediately after the face. We have Ammar, may Allah be pleased with him, who narrated, indeed the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, struck the earth lightly with the palms of his hands, then blew into them to blow off the extra dust, and wiped his face and hands with them. Tayammum becomes nullified as soon as water is available or the occurrence of any one of the nullifiers of wudu, like passing wind, or the occurrence of what necessitates bathing, like having a wet dream. It also becomes nullified due to the absence or discontinuation of any reasons, for example, sickness, etc., that made it possible for tayammum to be performed instead of wudu. The scholars have noted some points concerning tayammum. The first point is that making tayammum after relieving oneself in the event that one is unable to use water and praying is better than praying with wudu while forcefully retaining urine and feces. The second point is that it is permissible to perform tayammum by using a wall or prayer mat, etc., if soil or dust is present on them. And it is permissible for the person who performs tayammum to pray as many obligatory or optional prayers as he wishes, as long as the tayammum remains valid and intact. They also stated that it is correct for the person who performed tayammum to lead the one who has performed wudu in salah. The Prophet approved of the action of Amr ibn al-As, may Allah be pleased with him, when he led his people in prayer after performing tayammum due to the extreme cold. The scholars have stressed that a person who has performed tayammum and prayed but later finds water before the time of that particular prayer having finished doesn't have to repeat his or her prayer. As on the authority of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, two men went on a journey, and when the time of salah, or the prayer, came, they had no water to perform wudu. They both performed tayammum from pure earth, and then prayed. Thereafter, they found water within the time of the prayer, or salah. One of them repeated his salah after performing wudu, but the other did not. Afterwards, they both reported the incident to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and he said to the one who did not repeat his prayer, you followed the sunnah, which means what you did was correct and in accordance with my way, and your prayer sufficed you. He then said to the other companion who repeated his prayer, you have a double reward. The person who performed tayammum but finds water before or whilst offering salah must make wudu. The Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, said, indeed, clean earth is a source of purification for a Muslim, even if he does not find water for 10 years. But whenever he finds water, he should wipe his skin with it, because that is good for him. Nothing should prevent a Muslim from observing salah, and he also must not delay it. If he is incapable of using water, or he is not able to find it, he should perform tayammum, and if he is not able to perform tayammum, he should pray without purification.